Charlie.
Senate and House conservatives have said that they want a sort of a return to the 2015 Obamacare repeal effort. If that effort landed on the president's desk, would he sign it?
Well, I think the effort that's going through right now is the vehicle that's got is what people are on board with. I think one of the things that we have to remember is that the process, this three-pronged progress, is done for a particular reason. The reconciliation process, which I know for most people, it sounds like a very arcane inside baseball congressional term, but it only allows for certain things to happen in that repeal process. And that's why we've been very clear, and I think Paul Ryan laid out, Dr. Price has laid it out, and Mick Mulvaney is laying it out when he goes up to the Hill, that there's a reason that we keep talking about it in three prongs. Because there's only so many things that you are legally allowed to do through the reconciliation process. When the Democrats jammed this through, they did it in a way that they did it basically in two steps. They jammed it through the reconciliation process, number one. And number two, they gave broad authority to the Secretary of Health and Human Services so at the time that she could unilaterally do certain things with health care and implement certain things that we now have to undo in the same way. What we've done that's different, though, is frankly add a third prong, which allows for additional legislative vehicles that will go through the House and then in the Senate that will allow some of the core conservative principles that we've talked about for, frankly, decades, about allowing more competition, allowing people to pool, allowing people to do things that we think will allow lower prices to come out of the process. And I think that's a big difference in how...
He'll land on the president's desk. He would not.
He is going to land on his desk because we're going to go through this process.
Repeal without replace.
Well, again, I think the way that we're doing now, I think, is the right and the responsible way to do this. This bill will land on the president's desk. He will sign it. We will repeal Obamacare, and we will put into place a system that will be patient-centered, that will allow the American people to have greater choice and lower costs.